Welcome, SkySlopers. In this video, we're going to take a deep dive into the SkySlope Forms tool, walking you through the complete forms workflow start to finish. To get started, here we are on the Forms dashboard. Now, if at any point you get stuck or have a question, click on the Help button at the top of the page. If you click Help Documentation, you'll be able to browse all of our available SkySlope Forms tutorials, which cover just about any topic you can imagine. You can also register for a SkySlope Forms training session hosted by our learning and development team. Our customer support team is also available around the clock, so an answer is always just a click away. Now, let's get started with some of the basics. Before using SkySlope Forms, it's important to ensure your account is set up and ready to go. In your user profile, make sure you provide your name, email address, license number, and brokerage information. Here's where you can also grant access to team members, manage your forms libraries, and your account preferences. Now, let's take a look at the top navigation bar. Clicking on Files will always bring you back to the Forms dashboard. On the template page, you can create and manage personal forms templates and browse any brokerage templates available to you. You can use the Browse Libraries page to browse forms from your forms libraries at any time, and you can use the Clauses page to create and manage your own library of personal clauses. Back on the Forms dashboard, you have two view options to choose from, Grid View and List View. And you can always use the search bar to locate a particular file. Now that we've gone over some general navigation, let's dive into the SkySlope Forms workflow. When you're ready to prepare forms for a client, or even if you just want to take SkySlope Forms for a spin, you will start by creating a file. Start by selecting the file owner, which will either be yourself or someone else if you're creating a file on their behalf. Then, select the representation for this file and enter the contact information for the clients. Next, you can enter the property information if applicable. If you have an MLS number, you can use the Import MLS data tool to import key details from the MLS and save yourself time. Finally, you'll give your file a name so that it's easy to find later. You can choose between the address, the primary client's name, or type in your own file name. You can also select a forms template when creating your file, and all of the forms from that template will be added automatically. When you're ready, click Create to create your file. Next, you'll land on the Add Forms page. Here, you can filter by library and search by name to locate the forms you need. You can click on a form name to preview the form before selecting it and adding it to your file. Once you've located a form you need, click Add. You can search for and add as many forms as you need. After you've selected your forms, click Next to add them to your file. And now, here we have our forms file with the forms we selected. To add another form, you can always click the Add Forms button to select additional forms from your forms libraries. If you have a document saved on your computer that you want to add to your SkySlope Forms file, click Upload Documents. Then select the document to upload. Now, we're going to begin filling out our forms to prepare them to be signed. After selecting your forms, click Fill and Send. Here we are on the form filling page. We have some other resources that go over this process in great detail, so I'm going to give you a quick overview. You can use the page dropdown to jump to a specific page in this envelope, or click on a document name in the left column to jump to that document. You can also use the document list on the left to change the order of the documents, as this is the order the documents will be signed in. Now, some information on your forms will be auto-filled with your account information and the property information you entered when you created this file. Proceed to fill out your forms as necessary anywhere there is a blue field. You can click the paint bucket to access more form filling tools. And when you're ready to move forward, click Prepare Signature. Here, you can give your envelope a name and set your signer actions. You can choose between Needs to Sign, Receives a Copy, and No Action. After clicking Next, you'll be taken into DigiSign, where you can prepare the signatures and initials on your envelope. One of the main benefits of using SkySlope Forms is that when you select forms from your forms libraries, all of the signature, initial, and date blocks will automatically be placed for you. You can give all of the forms a quick once-over to ensure everything is to your liking. If you have a document in your envelope that you uploaded, rather than selecting from a forms library, you will need to manually place those signature and initial blocks as needed. Simply select the block type that you need from the DigiSign toolbar and click onto the document to place the block. Go ahead and manually place any additional blocks that you need. When you're ready to send the documents out for signature, click Send. After clicking Send, you can customize your email subject line and message that will be included with the invitation to sign. And finally, click Send for signatures, and off it goes. If you are a signer on the envelope, you can click Sign Now to complete your portion. From within your forms file, you can always navigate to the Envelopes tab to manage any of your sent envelopes. From here, you can send reminders and download completed documents. Now, if your brokerage also uses SkySlope Suite to submit documentation for listing and transaction files, there is an important next step. After you create your SkySlope Forms file, you need to do the same in SkySlope Suite to link the two files. Let me show you how. On the SkySlope dashboard, click Create New and then select your file type. When you're prompted to select your address, you will have two options: use the address lookup tool or by selecting a forms file. When you select a forms file and use that file to create your suite file, the two files will be linked. Linking your files means that all property data and all of your signed documents will automatically transfer from SkySlope Forms to SkySlope Suite. This is a huge time saver, and we definitely recommend taking this step. And there you have it. That's everything you need to know to get started using SkySlope Forms. If you have any other questions, please reach out to our support team or browse our collection of forms tutorials at support.skyslope.com. Happy skysloping!